Good morning, student. I am your Stephen sir from Ikra English Medium. Today I am going to teach you subject English. Class 11. Book will be Hornbill textbook. So chapter number 2. We are not afraid to die if we can all be together. Which is written by Gordon Cook and Alan East. So today I am going to give you a summary of We Are Not Afraid to Die if we can all be together. So please pay attention. We are not afraid to die if we can all be together. Summary tells about the extreme bravery and skill exhibited by Gordon Cook. Gordon Cook's family and crew men in a war with water and the waves for existence. In the month of July, in the year 1976, The writer, his wife Mary, son Jonathan, and his daughter Suzanne set sail for Plymouth in England to duplicate the round the world journey made 200 years ago by Captain James Cook. They took the trip to the professionally designed ship named the Wave Walker, accompanied by two sailors, Larry Vigil, who was an American, and Herb Sailor, a Swiss, to tackle on the world's coarsest ocean, Southern Indian Ocean. The first portion of the journey, that is about 1,05,000 kilometers up to the Cape Town, passed off very enjoyably. On the second day out of Cape Town, they started to encounter strong windstorm. Windstorms did not worry about the narrator, but the heights of the waves was alarming, up to 15 meters above, that was as high as the main mast. On the 25th of the December, the writer's ships reached in the Southern Indian Ocean, that was about 3,500 kilometers to the east of Cape Town. The family welcomed the new year of the ship. At the dawn of 2nd January, the waves were huge in size, unfriendly weather, and massive waves forced the sailor to slow the speed of the ship, drop the storm jib, and take various other precautions. The risk was so obvious that the sailor accomplished a life raft drill, attached the lifeline boat and the life jacket. Unexpectedly, at 6 p.m., a traffic explosion shook the wave walker and the writer was thrown overboard. The wave walker was about to overturn when other massive wave hit it, threw it upright one more time. The writer was thrown back again on the deck. His head and ribs were smashing, touching the walls of the wave walker. In spite of a lot of injuries, the writer took charge of the situation and decided to handle it on his own. Larry and Herb started jumping out of water from the ship. The author somehow managed to cover the canvas across the gaps to stop the water from entering into the ship. Moreover, their hand pump stopped functioning and the electric pump short circuits at the same time. Luckily, the writer found a spare electrical pump that was in working condition. The entire night, everyone was pumping, steering, repairing, and sending radio signal for help. The author checked the carts and found that he is in Amsterdam. A French scientific base was their last hope. Sue and Joe got heavily injured, but they were not afraid to die if they were all together. Sue had got swelling and she was having a deep injury. Moreover, the writer became extra determined to see the courage of his children. Finally, they were able to touch the Lie Amsterdam. It was a volcanic island where 28 inhabitants were ready to receive them. So, this was the story. So, basically, there is a conclusion, I will tell you. To sum up, we are not afraid to die. If we can all be together, we can say that collective power of unity and the never failing confidence of the sailors made it possible for them to survive and come out from the jaws of death. So this was the explanation of this lesson. Thank you so much.